to the business brief. You guys like those throwbacks? Those are some of the songs I think of when I think about sports. We have an all-star themed show for you today. Let's get to our first guest, David Trivari. I have wanted you to come on for so long. I love seeing you fight with the sports commentators.
Thank you.
even your haters are kind of funny in your comment section.
Yes.
Thank you so much for joining us. So tell us about your show.
Well, first of all, Natasha, thanks for having me on your show. I do appreciate it. As far as the show, it's Sports Live and ATL on YouTube. Been doing it since 2009. It's about sports. It's about Atlanta sports, streaming football games, basketball games, baseball, interacting with my people, promoting people, and just doing something that I enjoy doing. I've been doing my whole life. And I would be remiss if I didn't shout out my mom.
Hey, Mom.
I love you. Thank you very much for all your support. Jeff, thank you very much, too.
You gotta always give a shout-out to Mom, right?
Mom love. Mom love.
So tell us a little bit about yourself. Where are you from, and how did you make your way to Atlanta?
Well, I was born in California.
Surfer boy?
Well, I guess. I mean, I guess I could try. I mean, I play air guitar, too, so what does that mean?
Well, there you go. Yeah, I'm in the right category.
I lived in California just for a couple of years and then moved to Atlanta and just basically back and forth between Atlanta and Miami, So my roots are Atlanta sports. I breathe Atlanta sports. You know,
we know. Every single Atlanta team.
Yes.
Business Brief listeners, if you ever want to know what's going on, tune in to his YouTube show. And even the other day with Tiger and Lloyd being fired, I thought, what does David have to say?
Yeah, well, a lot of people were hitting me up about it. I actually called it on one of my...
Did you get him fired?
Maybe he saw my channel in live.
You're not a fan of his.
Maybe he was pressing himself after listening to me talking rant about him. But I wish him nothing but the best. I just felt like we needed a change because when you're looking at the Hawks and everything, they didn't know how to close. They weren't prepared, and it's unfortunate. But Lloyd, you will be okay, sir.
Yes, he's talented,
you.
Right?
Yeah, absolutely.
He can still have a successful career and everything.
Absolutely. Hit me up if you need. Maybe I can give you some tips.
You have all the tips, too.
Yes, ma'am.
And what about Tiger? You've been praying for him? What are your thoughts on his accident?
I only know brief parts of it, but I do know that he is well. I'm glad about that. I don't know all the inside and outs of what happened. But anytime a human being is involved in an accident, you wish the best. And I'm glad that there was, he's recovering. Which, I mean, Tiger Woods, clearly one of the best golfers in sports, one of the best athletes in the last 15 years or so. So,
And if he can recover and come back, then if anybody can, it's
him. Tiger, give me some tips. I would love to learn how to drive. With my granddad, I hit the ball in the woods and the trees a lot of times.
Okay. Also, you golf like me then.
I don't know. Putt golf, mini
like
golf.
I like to aim for the sand, you know?
I just look at the ball, you know, hit and swing.
Uh-huh. How funny. So, All-Star Weekend. Mm-hmm. Now, we know... our Madam Mayor is not happy with everybody being here, okay? But it's here. All-Star Weekend is here in Atlanta. What can we expect from the game?
Somebody's going to win and somebody's going to lose.
Is that the only thing you're confident in saying?
Yes.
No East Coast versus West Coast?
Well, it's going to be – it's a little different than what it used to be growing up for me. It was Eastern Conference, Western Conference, and now they still have it, but it's more Team LeBron, Team Durant. It's more of a –
popularity contest.
Yes, I mean it was more competitive back then. I am disappointed that there's no Atlanta Hawks representing here in Atlanta. But
yeah, how does that work?
Well,
I mean Trey is pretty good, I would say.
He's good, and John Collins is amping, and I've been hard
and
on.
And it's in our city. How disrespectful is that?
It is disrespectful. They need me to. I'm going to hit up NBA commissioner after this and find out. But to me, I think it's really because I don't think there's a lot of fans allowed, and because I believe if this unfortunate. Pandemic didn't happen, that I feel like with the packed State Farm Arena, we all know the guests here probably would believe it that they would be in it. Mm-hmm. But unfortunately, they're not, and they can rest up and make a run at the NBA title.
Sure. And speaking of the pandemic in sports, we saw the NBA have a very successful season with the bubble.
Yes.
Why do you feel like other sports didn't have that same level of success or commitment to do the same thing? When you look at the numbers.
Right. Well, as far as success goes, I just think there are some sports that are more popular when it comes to television and live events. Because you could go to a basketball game and watch it straight through. Baseball has been considered a yawning sport throughout the years where the dog days of summer. People kind of doze off. I just think Atlanta and just sports in general, it's a football and a basketball environment, and I think if you go on YouTube and everything, it's really basketball and football. But I just think they were trying the best that they could to try to keep the health of all the players and fans. And it's unfortunate, but I think it's slowly coming back, and you will see me at some games again soon.
There you go. Given your opinion to anyone about anyone, you are fearless when it comes to that.
Yes, I've always been an aggressive talker and stuff. And, besides myself on YouTube, I did want to give a special shout to Don Forever. I love Atlanta
Don
Sports.
Don Forever.
Yes, he's
one
really
of your sports buddies.
Yes, he's really good at what he does, and he reps a lot of Atlanta teams. And his moniker is, I think he says something like "real Atlanta podcast." Check him out and check out NorbCam of the Seattle Seahawks. These are good guys that I've collabed with, and there's plenty for everybody.
Mm-hmm. Cool. And let's talk about your YouTube show a little bit. So you stream a lot of the games. How are you able to do that? Because sometimes you can't really find which channel the games are on. Is it TNT? Is it local? Mm-hmm. Is it cable? Is it what? But I always see games on your channel. How are you able to do that?
Well, I'm like David Copperfield. I'm a magician. I just use the hands. I just use the hands, and I start searching. You could go on. There's passes for all the leagues you could watch. You could stream the games. I do them on my phone. I would prefer to watch it on television and do it because I get a broader picture of the game itself. But I find time to do it. I find ways to do it because I know what I do. I love sports. I love interacting with the people. And, unfortunately, some people aren't able to watch a lot of the games, and they rely on us YouTubers to give them, the following. And I love all my subscribers. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much. Without y'all, I couldn't make it.
Yes. And let's talk about that. You're actually able to monetize off of your views and everything.
Yes.
How does someone go about that for all these content creators out there who are looking to do the same thing?
Well, one thing I always tell everybody is, first of all, you don't want to forget where you started. Everybody started at zero. You need to be consistent with your content. You need to be prepared. You need to be planned. You need to have a framework of what you want to do. Don't listen to anybody that says you cannot do it, because the first way to success is to be positive, because you're looking out for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Be positive in what you're doing. Hold your convictions. Stay strong.
Continue no matter how many likes or views you get.
Yes, and I get a bunch of dislikes. Thank you, dislikes. I appreciate it.
But again, at least they're funny.
Yes.
If you're going to troll me, at least be funny.
Well,
you know?
there are some good ones if you look at the section. But but even with the positive and the negative and the trolls and you say haters, I still appreciate everyone, because if it were like an old saying goes, haters are my motivators.
Mm-hmm.
That's not my main thing. My main thing is just being me. But, everybody contributes to the channel.
And your fans are so consistent.
Yes.
They tune in every week. Even when I was looking for the whole Lloyd thing, I'm like, what happened? What's his position? I know he's a coach. Is he, I went right to your page.
Yes.
And I can see everybody tuning in.
Yes.
Trying to find out what they're not going to see on First Take or, the other sports shows.
Well, I never claimed to be Stephen A. Smith and all these guys. I'm just David. But my comment section is very knowledgeable. April's of Productions, Asia Green, shout out to you guys. Shout out to all you guys who make it fun for me.
Are these some of your subscribers?
Yes. And I've actually met a lot of people from YouTube. I've been on ESPN.
Mm-hmm.
I've traveled to Philadelphia for the Falcons game. We lost, of course. I was front row to see that debacle.
Uh-huh.
And I went to New Orleans and saw us lost. So people call me Jinx. So
so you shouldn't travel with the team then.
Yeah, but that's not going to stop me.
But can Freddie Freeman give you credit for his good luck?
Absolutely.
With the twins?
Yeah.
I love that story.
Or the Marcelo Zuna, with the uh-huh. little click and the stuff. Thank you for coming back, Marcel.
And for those of you who don't know, Freddie Freeman with the Braves, he and his wife just had twins. But get this. They actually, doctors told his wife that they could not have kids after their first child.
Really?
So they found a surrogate and they were ready for the transplant procedure. And then his wife got pregnant. So they have two babies just a few weeks apart. How awesome is that?
She's
I thought it was the
she's got a lot of long nights.
And
so does Freddie.
Yeah, that is true.
A lot of long nights.
So you're not going to make any predictions for the game this weekend. You just said somebody will win. I guess your guys aren't in it. So
well, I'm neutral because I believe whether you're playing exhibition games or spring training or All Star games or MLB All Stars or Pro Bowls, you play to win. You're a competitor.
Mm-hmm.
I played sports. I was always a competitor. And but if I had to pick, I would stick with the Eastern Conference because the Hawks are in it. The Hawks are in the East, and I would say the Eastern Conference.
So go East.
Yeah,
home team.
Yeah, the way the scoring
home
is.
Home squad, I guess.
Yes, the way the scoring is, I would say 270 to 269. There's no defense, so it'll be a lot.
Is that a roundabout way of saying nobody can play defense?
They don't even try to play defense.
They just go shoot.
They dunk, shoot.
Steven, what's his name? Who's married to Ayesha Curry? What's his name? Steph Curry.
Stephen Curry, yeah.
Just shoot.
Right? A lucky dude, yeah. Stephen
so
Curry, how you doing?
What have you learned about being a content creator that can help others?
I've learned that things don't happen overnight. You got to be patient. Mm-hmm. You have to commit to it.
And it's a lot of time because your content, oh my gosh,
yes.
You have a lot of it.
Yeah, thank you. People don't understand, you know, anybody can just click record and do a video or a game stream. You have to be engaging. You know, people say I have a personality. I don't have the best personality in the world.
I think so.
Well, I appreciate it. Same here. I feel the same about you. But I'm humble. And I just come on and do things that I've done my whole life and most importantly, you need to appreciate your people because mm-hmm. your people are what make you. So just stay focused.
No matter what the numbers are.
No matter what the numbers are, don't go on there. And I've been guilty of it in the past until I finally realized that the content that you provide and all the information is based on your effort and what you put in. If you put forth all that effort, it shows in your work. Always be prepared. Always know what you're going to talk about. Know when to stop. Know how to ignore. Know how to just focus and just be ready. And good or bad, just do your thing and make it happen. And, you know, there's plenty for everybody. And don't let anybody tell you can't do it.
There you go. And here are a few fun facts about the All-Star Game and its history. The first game was played in 1951. I didn't know it had been around that long.
Yeah.
Did we even have basketball teams in every city then?
In the 50s, yeah. In Atlanta was in St. Louis.
Is that when the Celtics were like really good and stuff? Is that that era or no?
Yeah, when all the Celtics, Lakers, when all the teams, unlike Atlanta, can win titles.
Oh.
I know, right?
Here you go.
I'm harsh on Atlanta. I'm extremely harsh.
Now, the youngest NBA All-Star at the age of 19 was Kobe Bryant in 1998.
Rest in peace, Mamba, yes.
At 21 years old, LeBron James became the youngest player to be named All-Star Game MVP. Mm-hmm. That was back in 2006. And the oldest NBA star player ever was Kareem Abdul-Jabbar in 1989. He was 41.
Yes.
My husband always says he never gets enough credit.
Yes. Hey, Will. How are you, sir?
Hi, honey. Are you listening? Your favorite sportscaster is here. Your fuss buddy.
Yes. Oh, in case everybody don't know, I will be the next MVP of the All-Star Game because I just got notification I've been selected. So I'm going to go there, put on my Hawks jersey, and do what I got to do.
Breaking news right here on the business.
Breaking news on the business brief.
When we come back, I'm going to have a conversation with my DJ Dre about his All-Star Weekend event. I can't wait to tell you more about that. And he's going to take us behind the scenes of the day in the life of a DJ. Is
nice.
It a career you ever thought about? He'll tell you everything you need to know. More of the business brief when we come back.
I'm hard on the phone.
Is that it for me?
I don't see my wipes.
Am I doing another clip or is that it?
You're gonna come back.
Good. So when I come back, I can do my Twitter, my
Yeah, you want to do it now? You can do whatever you want.
Okay.
I'll be like, I gotta get some white so I can serve.